This story has been taken from the Adventures of Tom Sawyer. Let's know the character of this lesson. Tom, he is the main character of the story. Ben, he is one of Tom's friend. Jim always helps Aunt Polly, and Aunt Polly is, you all know that by the name only you can recognize that he is Tom's aunt. Let's start the story. It was a Saturday morning. Then school was closed. All the children were ready to play. It was a brilliant day. The sun was shining bright. The birds were chirping. The trees and flowers looked fresh and lovely. All the children were very happy. But Tom was also very happy. But Aunt Polly asked Tom to whitewash the fence. Tom was very sad. Holding a long brush in one hand, a bucket full of white paint in the other, he was punished. His aunt told him to whitewash the fence. You all know the meaning of fence. Fence means charo taraf ghar ki jo diwar hoti hai, that is called fence. Tom looked sadly at the fence. How high it is. How long it is. 9 feet high, 30 yards long. Tom put his brush into the whitewash. He drew it slowly across the fence. It made a very small white mark. Tom tried again. Another very small white mark. Tom sat down. He sighed heavily. Sighed heavily means long breath. What long breath Tom ne liya. And it was really a difficult task. What Tom said, that it is a very difficult task. For a child, it is a difficult task to whitewash a fence. That too on a holiday. And it was a Saturday. And it was a holiday of the school. And Tom got punishment of whitewashing the fence. Just then, Tom saw Jim carrying a bucket. He was going to fetch some water from the village pump. The other boys will be there at the pump. What Tom said, that Jim is going to enjoy, all the friends will be there near the pump. And thought Tom, so he made the idea of meeting his friend. What he thought? He thought that I must go and meet my friend. He called Jim, let me fetch the water while you whitewash the fence. What he said? He said, Jim, that let me whitewash the fence and I'll go and bring water for you. Oh no, replied Jim. What said Jim? Jim said, no, I cannot do that. Aunt Polly said that I must not help you. Aunt Polly has said that I must not help you. She said that you must do whitewash yourself. I will give you a marble. And Tom started giving him bribe. Tom said to Jim that I'll give you marble if you let me fetch the water. A marble? Let me see it. Then Jim asked, show me the marble. What type of marble you're going to give me? Tom held out the marble in his hand. Tom showed the marble to Jim. Jim looked at it. But Aunt Polly was close behind him. And Aunt Polly was standing behind them. She hit him hard. Jim quickly picked up the bucket and went running down the street. Tom started his work again. Aunt Polly went back into the house satisfied. Now Aunt Polly thought that now Tom has started whitewashing. Tom stopped working. He sat down to look at his treasure. And he was having lot of toys with him. He started looking at his treasure. He had some marbles, pieces of strings, few broken toys. No one will whitewash the fence for these, he thought. And now Tom started thinking by looking at his treasure that nobody will whitewash my fence by taking these marbles and strings and all. No, I must think of a better plan. And now Tom started thinking of a better plan. Soon he had an idea. And now he got another idea. He saw Ben Rogers coming down the street. He saw his friend Ben Rogers who was coming down the street. Tom pretend karna means bahane banana. Tom pretended not to see him and began working hard. Tom started whitewashing the fence in a harder way. He worked harder than ever. Ben was eating an apple. What was Ben doing? Ben was eating an apple, looking very happy in a playful mood. He came up to Tom. He rubbed his eyes. And what happened? He rubbed his eyes and saw that Tom was whitewashing the fence very smartly. "Why, Tom?" he cried in great surprise. Ben asked, "Why, Tom, kya baat hai? You are whitewashing the fence in a very good mood. You are working?" Tom said nothing. He was working very hard and he went on whitewashing the fence. He looked very interested in his work. "Tom, you are working?" Ben repeated. Ben again asked, "Tom, you are working?" "Oh, it's you, Ben. I did not notice you." Now Tom looked at him and he said, "Oh, Ben, I haven't seen you. Do you like working? Don't you want to play?" Ben asked Tom, "Do you like working? Don't you want to play?" "This is not work," Tom quietly said. Tom said, "This is not a work which I am doing. I am whitewashing. It is not a work." "Not work," Ben explained. "Oh no, I like it. It is really fun. Tom said that it is really a fun. "Have you ever whitewashed a fence?" "Well, no, I haven't." Now Tom said, Tom asked Ben that, "Have you ever whitewashed the fence? It is really a very wonderful work, very enjoyable work." For a time, Ben stood watching Tom. Tom paid no attention to him. All his attention was given to his work. At last, Ben said, "Let me whitewash a little." Ben asked Tom that it seems a very interesting work. "Why don't you give me? I want to whitewash the fence." "Oh no, Ben, I am going to make this fence look fine. Everybody can't do this, that. It's very difficult. Besides, it's interesting also." What did Tom said, Ben, "You know, you cannot do that. It is a very interesting work and you cannot do. Let me do." And repeatedly, Ben was asking that, "I want to do the work." "Let me do a little," begged Ben, as he was tempted to do it once. "No, I am sorry, Ben, but you can't do." Aunt said, "I must do it myself." Now Tom said, Ben, "You cannot do, and Aunt Polly has told me that I have to do this work. I have to finish this work myself. If you do it, you will make a mistake. You will spoil everything." Then Ben said, "I won't make a mistake. I'll be careful. You can have an apple if you let me." And what did Ben said? Ben said that if you'll give me to whitewash the fence, you have my apple, eat my apple, and I will whitewash the fence in a very good way. Tom's idea worked. Now, what was the planning of Tom worked. Pretending to be unwillingly, he handed the brush to Ben. Ben worked hard and harder. Tom sat eating Ben's apple and watching him. And what happened? Tom took the apple and started eating, and he sat beside him, and Ben started whitewashing the fence. When Ben had done enough, other boys came along. At first they laughed at Tom, but soon they were whitewashing the fence. Of course, they had to give their best for the work. By the end of the day, Tom had 12 marbles, a tin soldier, a key, a dog's collar, the handle of a knife, and 4 pieces of orange added to his previous treasure. Soon the fence had 3 coats of whitewash on it. Tom discovered 2 laws that day. First was, if a man has to do something hard unwillingly, that becomes a work for him. If he likes to do something hard willingly, then it becomes a fun for him. Have you got the point, beta? If you want to do any work, difficult work, you should do it willingly. If you do not want to do the work, that work will become difficult for you.